Good evening. He was a Mr. Big of Sydney's drug underworld with close bikie links. But now Alen Moradian is the latest victim of our escalating gangland war. The 48-year-old was gunned down during a brazen daylight ambush in the eastern suburbs. Police say he had a target on his back.
It's rare to see a gangster's gun hours after it killed. But this is the pistol used to execute one of Sydney's criminal kingpins. Another deadly hit in the city's bloody gangland war.
This is a well-planned, executed murder of a high-level criminal identity.
Police rushed to a Bondi Junction apartment building around 8:15 this morning. In the underground car park, Alen Moradian was dead in the front seat of his car.
He was sort of face down in the police over him. I thought they were sort of trying to arrest him. I didn't realise he'd been shot.
The gunman managed to get away in a Porsche SUV before dumping it 1 kilometre away. But they failed to torch it, left behind the gun, bullet casings, a phone, all key evidence. A second car was found in Zetland. It was set alight.
Both those vehicles were looking at the links between to the shooting and to any persons involved in the shooting.
At least two, police believe.
It's absolutely crazy. It's just like, you don't expect this in your building.
Alen Moradian was well known to police. In 2011, he was jailed for his role in the Golden Gun drug ring, which imported at least 200 kilograms of cocaine into Australia. His crime was motivated by personal profit and greed, a judge claimed. The proceeds used to deck out his Pennant Hills mansion, nicknamed the Versace Palace, including a ceiling painted like the Sistine Chapel.
Underworld sources say Alen Moradian was involved in a secret cartel that controlled Sydney's drug markets. His position considered higher than notorious crime families. Who wanted him dead remains unknown, but retaliation is highly likely.
Moradian's own wife once dubbed him the Tony Soprano of Australia's cocaine trade. She even warned him he would not survive if he kept showing off. She was right.
He obviously had a big target on his back.
And Bill Hogan is at the scene tonight. Bill, how concerned are police about revenge attacks?
Well, Mark, there are certainly fears for retribution. Alen Moradian played a major role in organised crime with close links to the Comanchero bikie gang. It's very unlikely that they will let this execution go unpunished. But of course, the 48-year-old knew that he lived a lifestyle that came with risks. It's believed over the last 12 months he's been concerned for his life. He's changed addresses, he's changed cars in hope that nobody would find him. But this morning they did. Mark, at the end, the criminal mastermind couldn't keep himself safe.
Bill Hogan with the latest from Bondi Junction. Thank you.
Afternoon, I'm Detective Superintendent Danny Doherty, Commander Homicide Squad, State Crime Command. I'm here with Detective Superintendent Jody Radmore, the Commander of Eastern Suburbs Police Area Command. We're both here together today to outline the events of this morning and also answer any questions you may have. Just to recap, emergency services and police responded to Spring Street Bondi Junction around 8:30 a.m. this morning to reports of a man being shot. At the time, police found a man, commenced CPR, tried to assist him with the assistance of paramedics, but he could not be revived. At this stage, the man has not been formally identified. He's a 48-year-old Bondi Junction resident. But we'll answer more questions about that later on. In relation to shortly after that, police commenced an investigation a short distance away in James Street, Bondi Junction. Found a partially burnt out Porsche. That's now being examined as a crime scene. Later also, police found a Holden Commodore burnt out in Cook Lane at Zetland. That's also been forensically and ballistically examined. So both those vehicles, we're looking at the links between to the shooting and to any persons involved in the shooting. As a result of the investigation is ongoing, it's in its infancy at the moment. Homicide Squad detectives are taking carriage of the matter. However, that's with the assistance of Eastern Suburbs Police Area Command, who initially responded. and did a great job in relation to the three crime scenes. We've also been assisted by investigators from Central Met Region and also from various squads within State Crime Command, including Raptor Squad and Criminal Group Squad. The shooting this morning bears the hallmarks of an organised crime murder. It's been treated as that. That's why the Homicide Squad's taken carriage. We're focusing all our attention at the moment on obtaining CCTV and witnesses and gaining as much information as we can at the moment. Obviously, the crime scenes are being examined as we speak. It's just down the road. We're three crime scenes. We're looking for more CCTV. We're appealing to anyone who may have seen something or heard something, not only at the time, but the days leading up to the shooting, immediately after the shooting. And at this stage, we're working closely with Eastern Suburbs Police Area Command and the Central Metropolitan Region to make sure that the community of Bondi Junction is safe. We believe this is a targeted shooting, and we believe it's a targeted shooting of a high-level organised crime identity. Happy to take questions.
Denny, you know he's just looking that way. You know his history, but it's not public information yet. You know his history.
Yeah.
Is there any reason, do you have any evidence of why he might have been targeted?
As I said, he hasn't been formally identified. We believe he's a 48-year-old man from Bondi Junction with an extensive criminal history, well known to police. He's a high-level criminal identity. He's a major player, and because he's a major player in the organised crime network and also has links to Comanchero OMCG, high level, he obviously had a big target on his back.
Did the initial call come from someone who witnessed the shooting or someone who saw
Police were called and responded as a result of there were some shots fired. My understanding, I know there was a number of shots fired. We're talking about a safe community in Bondi Junction where the shots fired in an underground car park. So immediately, police were called. Emergency service responded very quickly. That's why they attempted to conduct CPR on the victim. However, that was unable to revive him. That's also why we found crime scenes, the vehicles, very quickly as well.
Was there any interaction?
You've got two cars. Is there a suggestion that there's more than one shooter?
We believe there's more than one shooter, but we still, as I said, the investigation's in its infancy. We believe the initial information was there was at least two shooters or two people involved. But again, we're canvassing and making inquiries as we speak. We're knocking on doors and interviewing people as we speak.
Was there any interaction with the gunman? Did you cross paths? Did police cross paths with these people?
My understanding is police responded around 8:30 a.m. And the man was found in his car in the underground car park and could not be revived.
Was it possible the shooting occurred before 8:30 a.m?
We believe the information that we've initially, again, this is all initial information. It happened, reports of the shots could have happened around 8:15. So we'll be appealing for anyone around that time who would have seen something unusual or suspicious leading up to 8:15 this morning or at the time of the shooting. So you've got to remember we're saying this is a well-planned, executed murder of a high-level criminal identity.
Is it a secure car park?
Well, it's an underground car park in Bondi Junction.
Yeah, were they able to get in,
Those inquiries are still being made.
What's the victim been doing for the last few years? I understand he's been in and out of prison, things like that, but for the last few years, what are his movements sort of thing?
Look, again, he's well known to police. He has strong, high-level links to the Comanchero OMCG. He also has high standing in the organised crime network. He's a major player with a big target.
Given that Comanchero move, is there any suggestion that it could be linked to the daylight shooting of Tabar?
Look, we're not going to speculate on every murder that's happened in Sydney in the last couple of years. All we know is this person would have been the intended target of the shooting and that he was a high-level identity in the criminal network. So he was a high-level target for these shooters.
Did he live alone
there? He all I can say is at the moment he lived in the Bondi Junction area and his next of kin have been informed.
Are you also investigating?
What was that, sorry?
Is there a weapon found in any of
the cars? The three crime scenes are being examined as we speak, both forensically and ballistically, and that's still ongoing.
Are you also investigating that shots may have been fired early on Monday morning as a possible warning?
Well, all I can tell you The information I have, the shots were fired and the incident happened around 8:15 this morning. Police and emergency service were notified about 8:30 and attended straight away, and to the point where they were trying to revive him. And again, found the burnout car, which was a Porsche, in James Street, Bondi Junction.
So I suppose for the police, you know, they didn't really know what they were going to face. They knew that there were shots fired. They went into an underground car park. So that would have been, a tough call.
Absolutely. And as police do, they run towards danger, not away from danger. And in this case, they tried to revive the person. And despite their efforts, were unable to revive him. Again, and they should be commended for their professionalism. Again, I'd like just to allay the fears of anyone in the Bondi Junction area, in this area. As we know, this is Tuesday morning in Bondi Junction. We don't expect this to happen. We don't expect it to happen anywhere. But we're working tirelessly with local police. But also, not only that, we have Raptor Squad and Operation Talon Police doing proactive suppression tactics as we speak. So there's an investigation going on. There's police out there now knocking on doors to make sure there's no retaliation or escalation. Thanks very much, everyone. Thank you.